All right, we're back out here in the woodyard. Got to continue working on this stack of wood here, the stack of white ash. I'm now on halfway through cord number 4. Leaves me three and a half cords left over here, and then I have another cord and a third on the other side. And it's early August right now, so it's time to get some more split. I need to get this filled back up. Hopefully I can have enough to last the rest of the season. We'll see. Been going like hotcakes recently, so it's okay. Okay for the money, but we can need to have more quantity. I'm gonna have to order another truckload here pretty soon, because we got, oh, I don't know how much we have left. The ash stops about right there. This is the first piece of oak, so ash kind of comes down here, and then this is all oak. The darker stuff on that end is all oak. So, starting a new little process today. I'm gonna cut rounds here, put the rounds in the basket, carry the basket over there. I got the wood splitter set up, staged, ready to go. So we'll split them out of the basket on that end. Kind of do some ergonomics, had the basket higher off the ground so that we don't have to be bending over so much. So here we go. All right, that was 21 minutes. And I got that whole pallet filled with white ash. I think if I had stacked it nicely, it's about a face cord, but maybe it'll be a face cord. We'll see. But we'll see now if that tractor can pick that up. I think it will. Should be no problems. But we'll see. Note to self, maybe not fill it up quite as high. I mean, I was able to lift it, but it does get a little unsteady if you get some uneven terrain. One of the back tires will start coming off the ground. But as you see, it lifts it fine. I mean, that's about as high as it'll go, maybe another couple inches. That's the lifting capacity of the actual hydraulics. I couldn't go any higher. So we'll start splitting this stuff. Well, that's it. One basket of firewood done. Dang near very close to face cord. Maybe just under. Hard to measure because I started over on that stack and I'm continuing over here. But just eyeballing it, it looks pretty close to the face cord. Pretty impressed actually. I mean, to get that much in there and minimize the waste and I guess dirt over here by my stacks, where all the cuttings over there. But then also I can lift the basket off the ground and makes it a little easier for splitting too. A little bit of kindling. So it's time to get back in the swing of things here, making firewood. Gotta get this white ash done, split and stacked, and then keep working on that oak. Because before I know it, I'll be running low on firewood, and I imagine once it starts cooling off, people will be buying more for heat when they're probably burning more when they're sitting around the campfires. Now that they know that they can get firewood here. And then they're buying in higher quantities too, because I'm selling a lot more of the loose stacks as well. So I need to hopefully some of the stuff I'm splitting today. I mean, it's August now. I don't think 3 months, maybe November, December, I don't think 3-4 months is going to be enough to get this stuff dry enough. It'll be ready next year for sure. So I guess once I sell out, I sell out. No more firewood. We'll see. All right, that's it. All pieces stacked. We got the Kioti over there holding this. The tray up, and that's it for the day. Warm summer day. So if you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and we'll try and get back to making more videos. It's been a busy summer, but we'll try and get more videos out as fall arrives and get back into the firewood season. So thank you for watching, and we'll catch you in the next one. Thanks, bye.